ladies and gentlemen, it's the moment you've all been waiting for. It's our main event of the evening. This one's sponsored by CLS Global Solutions. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the red corner from Reps MMA. Give it up for Karolina Marta Wojcik.
A battle for the contenders' world strawweight title, 115 pounds. We've got two of the very best girls in Europe, if not the world. And walking out to the cage is Karolina Wojcik, 5-1 as a pro, the EFC strawweight champion. That's the dominant promotion in South Africa. She's got Pitbull written on her top, and that's how she fights, Dean. Forward, pressure, constant aggression. And what are you looking for from Karolina tonight?
Oh, Wojcik, the Polish assassin, ranked number 3 in the UK and Ireland. Very tough and durable. A scary striker standing with her. It's like fighting in a pressure cooker.
Yeah, her cardio is fantastic. She rarely takes a backward step. She just surges forward and imposes her will on the girls that she's fought. As I say, 5-1 as a pro, 7-1 as an amateur. The only loss in the amateur slate was to Corey McKenna, who is one of the best young fighters on the planet, who will very soon be wearing gold in Cage Warriors. So this is the sort of level that Karolina is operating at. But she's got hands full tonight, Dean, with the lady we're about to see walk out, Evelina Wozniak.
Corner from Sesvani Schmuck, please welcome Yulina Wozniak.
Evelina Wozniak knocked out Anita Beckers cold, and I don't say that lightly. She knocked her out stone cold with the right hand. The sort of power you do not see from female MMA, especially down at 115 pounds, Dean. She is a dangerous lady.
Unbeaten in her pro career. She's currently top 15 in Europe, highly skilled, huge KO power in that right hand, as you said. Sets up the right hand with a left jab to the body. She'll move in and out of range, looking to land boxing combos, often the 1-2.
Evelina has won 8 straight fights. She's not lost for 4 years of either amateur or pro. She is a formidable opponent for Karolina Wozniak here. And as you'd expect, only the best for the contenders title here. 115-pound fight between these two supremely talented ladies. And as I say, you have to watch out for the right hand of Wozniak. It's just a question of whether or not she'll be able to land it with Wozniak constantly in her face as we go through the final checks here. 5 5-minute rounds for the contenders' strawweight title. And Evelina Wozniak enters the cage. And Dean, I've got goosebumps. I don't know about you. This is going to be a special fight.
This is for the Polish queen, the crown for this pro MMA strawweight title. It's going to go off, ladies and gentlemen. Keep your eyes on this one.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest will determine the strawweight contenders champion in the ladies division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the red corner, from Reps MMA, put your hands together for Karolina Marta Wojciech. And her opponent, standing across the cage in the blue corner, from Shevoni Schmuck, put your hands together for Yulina Wojciech. One more time, ladies and gentlemen, this title bout is sponsored by CLS Global Solutions and will be fought over five 5-minute rounds. Your referee in charge of the action, Mr. Sam Amidi.
Main event time, five 5-minute rounds to decide the strawweight champion of contenders. In the red corner, dressed all in black, is Karolina Wojciech from Reps MMA, 5-1 in her pro career, and she faces the unbeaten Iwelina Wozniak in the opposing corner in the purple, fighting out Shevoni Smok. 2-0 is Wozniak. As I say, look out for that huge right hand that she's got. And here we go, we're underway, Dean. Five 5-minute rounds.
Yeah, Wojciech's going to have to be very cautious of Wozniak's power, making sure she uses her excellent footwork just to simply not be for that counter right hand.
Yeah, look for Wozniak to throw the jab to the body and then come upstairs with a huge right hand. And you best believe that Wozniak is very aware of that right hand. She normally pressures constantly forward. Oi, nice kick there from Wozniak in the early exchanges, Dean.
Wozniak's got that beautiful boxing style for MMA. She keeps her hands up nice and high, turns the hip over, but she's equally ready for the takedowns. It's to be interesting to see which one of these ladies opts to take this fight to the ground after tasting the power of the other.
Wozniak pressing forward. She's got the height and reach advantage. She's a taller, longer lady in the cage tonight. It doesn't normally bother Wozniak. She's used to that. She lands a nice jab. Interesting early exchanges.
It's interesting to see Wojciech back off almost. She's usually the one that uses her aggressive striking style to put pressure on her opponent.
Oh, she got clipped. And Wozniak jumps on her back. She's riding her. She's got looking to sink the rear naked choke in, Dean. She rocked her with a right hand.
And what a leap. It's almost like she's playing a game of leapfrog straight into the hooks. Going to look for the rear naked choke here. She might look to parry that arm down to expose the neck on that side. You can see the way she's funneling the left arm downwards to try and get underneath the chin.
Wozniak is hand fighting, doing what she should be doing. And that was really quick, Dean. I think it was a right hand from Wozniak. Just staggered Wozniak. And then as she turned away, Wozniak just jumped on her back, and here we are.
Interesting to see Wozniak looking to take this to the ground, because that's going to give Wojciech an opportunity to recover. You know, she gets back to her feet here. They're going to, if they separate, they're going to start in the striking realm again. But it was interesting to see Wozniak not chase after and look for the finish.
And here, Wozniak, as I say, she's got Pitbull written on the top, and that's exactly what she is. She's tenacious. She does not stop coming forward. And they separate. First blood then to Wozniak with that big right hand and the threaten of the rear naked choke submission. Let's see what Wozniak can do to turn things around here.
Big leg kick from Wozniak. She's got such a mouth-watering style. It's just perfect for MMA. Her kicks, her punches, her ground game. Really exciting female fighter to watch.
Very, very big talent as Wozniak charges forward and gets shrugged off by Wozniak.
Wojciech now walking around on the outside. She does that to avoid damage and has this innate ability to draw her opponent in with this advanced footwork. But as of yet, she's not been able to land anything decisive when Wozniak comes forward.
You normally see a bit more aggression, don't you, from Wojciech? A bit more forward pressure, but I think she's struggling at the moment with the range and the power maybe of Wozniak, a little bit wary.
Yeah, Wozniak has definitely got a reach advantage in this fight, and she knows how to set up that power right hand. She's coming storming forward a little bit, dropping her hands as she comes forward, so let's see if Wojciech can time that. But she's a beast in the clinch, is Wojciech. Watch her press her head underneath her opponents to gain optimum control and then look for the takedown.
This is her wheelhouse, this is where she wants to be. As I say, constant forward pressure. Oi! Just tossed aside though by Wozniak, and again, she's looking to take her back, Dean. Impressive strength from Iwelina Wozniak.
Such explosive power in that frame. She really does make sure that she ticks all the boxes with regards to the technique. She doesn't throw arm punches. She uses her hips. She uses the power of her body, looking for the outside trip up against the cage here. Double underhooks, but not with the hands clasped. If she can clasp her hands together, she'll have better control over the body of Ocek.
So these early exchanges suggest that Wozniak is the stronger lady in there, which could well be a little bit demoralizing for Wozniak. She's used, as I say, to being able to physically dominate the people that she fights. Wozniak here looking to lead the leg away. Nice knee against the cage, and they separate.
What an entertaining fight here for the Pro MMA strawweight title in the female division. Such a massive platform in contenders putting on the best fights. All eyes are going to be on, not just in the UK, in Europe.
Absolutely, two of the best ladies in Europe, certainly. And you best believe that these two are very, very talented indeed. And whoever wins this title is going to be a real one to watch in the future. Ocek balls forward and again presses Wozniak to the cage, but she's not been able to have any joy so far, Dean, in terms of getting her to the floor.
Drop down for the single, now look for her to get back up to her leg. She could head inside or pop her head to the outside and do a head outside single and pivot round, but the time runs out.
Okay, so first round, first blood, you'd have to say, to Evelina Wozniak. Hopefully you get to see it on the replay. She landed a big shot, which had Wozniak scrambling, and then she put in some, here we go, hopefully we get to see this here.
Replay, the big right hand, body kick. This was early on in the round.
That was the kick. It was the punch that scrambled Wozniak a little bit.
Wozniak always looking to land.
There we go. It's that right hand. Yeah. Little shovel as she came in, as I say. And then look at her jump on the back. Unbelievable. That was so quick, Dean.
That was crazy. It's like watching a snake jump on its prey. This is just a testament to the level of these female fighters and what contenders brings to the MMA community, not just in the UK, but Europe, and bringing the best female fighters, you know, ranked third and ranked 15th, to come and duke it out for the gold here at contenders.
As I say, it looked like Wozniak was the stronger lady in that first round, but as I alluded to as they walked out, Wozniak is known for incredible gas tanker cardio. And it's obviously a five-minute round fight, and let's see if she can start to impose herself. Maybe Wozniak gets tired. Oh, will she? We do not know. We're about to find out. Second round, Karolina Wozniak, Evelina Wozniak for the women's strawweight title here at Contenders. Mark Heath, Dean Midhat here with you. And what a fight we are watching, Dean.
Wozniak now working around on the outside. She usually storms in with hooks and then circles off, but she's got to be very careful of that right hand. She's got almost pummeled the jab out, look to use the head movement and make Wozniak missed with that right. So she's going to slip off to her left side, maybe work the left hook right hand combination. Oh. Catches the kick. That's the danger of catching the kick. The counter from your opponent is the straight right.
Yeah, she caught the kick but then got punished with a right hand straight to the face from Wozniak. Wozniak looking for a way in, looking for a way to pick this lock. Wozniak is presenting in front of her.
Wozniak's using that left hook now. She's trying to deter Wozniak from firing that right hand out, because when the right hand goes out, it's not protecting your chin.
Wozniak pressing forward with the jab. She does have the reach advantage that we talked about already.
That when she's most exposed, Mark, when Wozniak comes forward, she puts her hands down, she leads with her chin sometimes. So if Wozniak can time that and move her head off the center line and make Wozniak miss and then come with those big power punches that we know her for, she might have some success there.
We shall see. Nice left hook there from Wozniak. Oi, there's that big right hand of Wozniak. Just misses, but it made a thud as it hit the gloves. Oi!
Wozniak storming forward, looking for a home for that right hand.
She knows she's got power in that right hand, Dean.
She's got to disguise it, though. I mean, almost certainly now, if we know that it's coming, Wozniak almost certainly knows it's coming. She's got to disguise it with leg kicks, combinations, fake the level changes, and then go upstairs with the right hand.
And she comes forward, and Wozniak grabs her. Wozniak presses her up against the fence. She landed a couple of shots there, Wozniak going in. And let's see who wins this grapple against the fence here.
Nice foot stops, yeah.
And they hurt.
She's just mixing it up in there, is Wozniak. Wozniak did a good job. Double overhooks, it looks like. She did a great job of defending those knees and keeping up upright against the cage. But she's got to start to funnel in for the unhooks or separate. Push on the head of Wozniak.
Go, constant motion from Voshek. As yet, he's wearing some damage to the face now as well, Dean. The nose is bloodied, which obviously affects her breathing. I want to encourage Wozniak as she comes forward again.
There's that leaping left hook. Voshek, there we go, leg kicks. I'd like to see him mix it up, fake the low shots. Even fake the takedowns, I'm just going to bring the hands down of Wozniak and make the head more available.
Leg kicks could be a big weapon here. Obviously, Wozniak is the taller lady. She's got more leg to kick. Oh! And she just was taking a knee to the face there, Voshek, as she came in.
She's looking to time that catch, initiate the clinch here. She's got to start thinking about pummeling in and dropping down to attack these legs, though. You know, in the upper body realms, Wozniak has proven to be very strong. As you can see here, she's diving for the underhooks. Voshek needs to go and attack the legs, maybe even go down and pick a low ankle kick, or look for the double legs and the single legs. Again, exposing the back here.
There we go.
Potential triangle. She's going to look to pop that left hand through.
First time Voshek's got the fight to the floor, though. This is good for Karolina Voshek. Now she's got some time to work here on the floor, Dean.
Voshek looking to work the ground and pound. She's got to pass the guard in this position, though. Up kicks here.
Got to watch those up kicks. They were nasty there. Kick the legs. And Wozniak is back to her feet. A reason to be cheerful there for Voshek. The first time she's got Wozniak to the floor. Hopefully give her some encouragement as the fight wears on. Oi! And that's the shot that knocked out Beckers in the last fight. The jab to the body and the right hand up top.
Voshek just a little bit more labored now with her kicks. She's kind of pulling them back a little bit too early, not really selling them enough. She's got to start thinking about implementing that low leg kick to take the spring out the step, fake the leg kick, then come upstairs with the left hook. We'll change the levels, but when she does it like that, we call it shooting naked. Like, you don't set it up so your opponent can see it coming early on and spawn evade.
Yeah, you've got to put some hands in front of it, haven't you? I have just noticed in this last round, Wozniak has started to shoot that jab to the body. As I say, that's when she likes to set up the big right hand. But Voshek takes Wozniak to the floor here.
She's got to maintain this position, though, because if Wozniak can sneak her head out of that position, she could potentially take the back of Voshek. That's why you saw Voshek hold on really tight to that head.
End of the second round, then. And that was a closer round, Dean. Voshek got Wozniak to the floor. As I say, reasons to be cheerful. What did you make of that round?
Yeah, I mean, Voshek's making the adjustments here. You see from the replay, she's catching the kicks. She's changing levels. She's going for takedowns. She's throwing a lot more kicks and using a bit more fakes and feints. She's not kind of storming forward like we're used to seeing her. She's starting to think outside the box now, up against the cage. You know, she's just surviving here, eating a few low knees to her thigh.
I'm really impressed with the range of weapons that Wozniak's using. You know, the knees to the leg there, the foot stomps as well. We've seen she's really using the full arsenal. But here, Voshek got Wozniak to the floor. And there you see, that's the jab to the body and the right up top. That's her favourite combination. That's the KO combination. You watch out for that as we get deeper into this fight. Third round coming up. Fight between two very talented female fighters here. Karolina Voshek and Evelina Wozniak for the contender strawweight world title. They're back underway. Voshek in the black, Wozniak in the purple.
Wozniak stalking for that left hook right hand combination. And again, separates from the clinch. Wozniak did a good job of really keeping Voshek on the outside, using the power punches to deter her coming in. See, as soon as she eats those punches, she just immediately backs out. I'd like to see her change levels. There we go. But again, she's got to put something before that, a kick, a punch combination, to really kind of catch Wozniak slipping in it, and it proves to be an easier takedown. She's got double underhooks here.
Sticking to her like Velcro here, Dean.
Yeah, she needs to do something with it, though. She's looking for the inside trip here, but she's going to fall foul. And here we go. Now she drops to the leg. We were speaking about this earlier. To attack the legs, they're not going to be as strong as the whole upper body of Wozniak.
Voshek has clearly decided this is the way to go, maybe not having the better of it on the feet. She wants to get this fight to the floor with the tenaciousness that is her trademark. And there we go, Dean. She pulls Wozniak to the floor. Nice takedown there from Voshek.
That's a big takedown, but she falls into the guard. She's got to think about passing the guard when the legs are open like that. She used to pass around into the side control position, look for the mount. to do more damage from there. If she sits in the guard here, she falls foul of the referee standing them up for one thing, but initially she can not do that much damage. She might fall foul to a submission, a triangle, an armbar here.
Wozniak just trying to hold on.
The ref calling for work. It's in danger of this being stood up.
That's exactly what Wozniak wants, of course. She's just holding on here, looking for that stand-up from referee Sam Amidi, who again claps and says, give me something. Wozniak pushes up, looking for stack. Wozniak. And here we go, back to the feet. Good work from Wozniak, Dean.
Wozniak now looking to shoot in. She's tasted now, she can work that single leg. She's going to hunt on that single leg head outside. Punches in the interim, switches to the double leg up against the cage. She's got to pull the hips away. Potentially go down and start to attack the single leg now. She can scoot round to her right side. She's going to start to attack that right side, the left leg of Wozniak. Wozniak did a good job of using the Kimura grip there to facilitate her escape and to prevent the takedown.
Look at this tenaciousness though from Wozniak. As I say, she's clearly decided this is the game plan that's got the best chance of working, and she is just sticking to Wozniak like Velcro, looking to wrap those hands around her and take her to the floor.
Wozniak pummeling for those unhooks. There we go, double pummels. She's got to get double unhooks, and she'll look to turn this position, maybe even look for the separation. Textbook did takedown defense, sorry, Mark, from Wozniak.
We're going back to the center of the cage, back to where Wozniak has had the better of it so far, the striking realm. Certainly Wozniak has made it clear that she thinks she can win this fight in a grappling match. She's got to be careful of that big right. Oh, good exchange there. Nice left hook there from Wozniak, Dean. Maybe the best punch she's thrown in this fight. She lands another couple, Dean. That'll give her reason to be positive. But then Wozniak shrugs off the shot.
Wozniak now just stalking on the outside. If she wants to sell the hand, she's really got to sell the hand. She's got to avoid that right. But she's got to look to really pressure forward and make Wozniak think upstairs, maybe even defend, then shoot down for the low single, low double.
What a high-level fight this is. Wozniak swings herself almost off her feet there with that big right hand. Fascinating technical battle as we get into the championship rounds. Again, Wozniak comes bullying forward, and the takedown, Dean, that's probably the easiest one she's scored so far.
Yeah, she pulled the trigger immediately. She didn't kind of work too long to switch between the body lock and the takedown. She went straight for the legs, bumped the hips off the cage, and sent Wozniak crashing to the mat.
Is the tide starting to turn here? Is Wozniak starting to impose her will on Wozniak? She certainly scored a couple of takedowns in this round. That was the easiest takedown she's scored so far. She's got to do some damage on the ground, Dean.
This is the question on my lips now. Has Wozniak done enough in the strength and conditioning, the cardio department, to keep up the furious pace? Because we know Wozniak really has the pace to go five fives. This is a championship fight, so Wozniak might be looking to really just wear down and then take an advantage. Whoa, hey, big knee.
Big knee to the face right in front of us. A couple of knees to the face there in the clinch from Wozniak. And there we go, Dean. End of the third round. Very interesting, Dean. Has the tide started to turn in that round?
If it has, I'll allude it more to the fact that Wozniak is not as springy, or she's not got as much endurance. You can see they're looking into the corner. She's got hands on her hips. So this doesn't seem like she's sitting down, but from the replay here, you can see the punches. She's throwing them quite wide out, looking for the right hand. And Wozniak's implementing the clinch a little bit more. You know, we've seen that from her previous fight. She's very dominating in the clinch. Great takedowns up against the cage. But I mean, looking at that, the wizard. Wozniak doesn't seem to have as much power as she did in the opening rounds.
Yeah, I do wonder if she's starting to tire. As I say, it's a 5 5-minute rounds. Wozniak certainly had her best round that last round. She started to impose herself on Wozniak, scored a couple of takedowns. And as we say, one thing you don't have to worry about with the Polish assassin Karolina Wozniak is her cardio. Her gas tank goes for days. And you just wonder now, is Wozniak able to keep up the pace here? Contenders 27. There's two more rounds. They call these the championship rounds for good reason, Dean, because this is often where the championships are indeed decided, and that could very well be the case again here. Contenders 27 round four between Karolina Wojciech and Iwelina Wozniak. And Wojciech is going to keep coming forward, you've got to think, in this fourth round, Dean.
Wojciech now selling the striking. You see what I mean about that jab? She's establishing it. She's looking like she wants to strike, using head work, moving her hips, moving her head, really just making Wozniak believe she wants to box. Then she'll change levels and look for the takedown.
This is the sort of fight, I think, that Wojciech wanted. She's come through the fire of that first round, and she's starting to drain the gas tank of her foe, Wozniak, here. You see she's looking more confident in the stand-up, Dean.
Wojciech using the jab a little bit more now. She's known for her excellent jab that she sets out to establish early on in the placement of power of the right hand, but she's not had an opportunity to land any power right hands, but the jab snuck through a little bit more, enough to make Wozniak believe it was a striking game for a second. And again, she changes levels, looks for the clinch, working for the takedown up against the cage.
Great work from Wojciech here. Pressing Wozniak into the cage again, grinding on her, hanging on her, making her carry her weight, trying to deplete her energy reserves as we're in the fourth round of this championship fight here.
Wozniak doing the correct thing, keeping the base wild, trying to pummel in that right hand. She wants double unhooks to gain more control over the body and circle out of this position. There we go, beautiful circle from Wozniak. There's the right hand landing on the chin, but shook off from Wojciech.
That makes you wonder, has Wozniak still got that explosive power that she had at the start of the fight? Has this wrestling heavy, grappling heavy approach from Wojciech started to pay dividends, as again she balls Wozniak back to the cage? And this is her world. She looks again for the takedown, Dean, looking for that single leg.
She's looking for the outside trip. She's going to circle around to her right side. Beautiful work straight into side control. She's got to make sure she passes that left leg. There we go. She's going to control the head and the arm now. And this is a position where she can do some damage, especially under the pro set rules. She can land some very damaging elbows from this position.
And here we go. Has Evelina Wozniak ever been this deep in her career? The fourth round, she's got a woman who's not going anywhere. She's hit her with some big shots. And Wozniak is still there, and now she's in side control on top of her with an apparently limitless cardio gas tank.
And we know from Wozniak's experience, she's got great takedown defense up against the cages, as we've seen for the duration of this fight. She creates space with underhooks on the feet, but can she do the same off her back? Can she use the power in her legs, get the underhook, look for the sweeps, and look for the turnaround in this fight?
Check, looking the knee on the belly here, looking for the mount. As I say, another step to imposing her will. We have some hair landed next to us on the announce table.
There's actually a lock of Wojciech's hair.
Yeah, I don't know when that came out.
The braids, I believe it came out in the cage and the ref's thrown it over the side. There's literally a lock of hair with blood in it from Wojciech. That's how hard these two females are fighting. She didn't pull it out on purpose, of course. It's in the transitions between the takedowns and the grappling, but it just shows how close Wojciech's trying to get and how much power is being implemented by Wozniak.
And that goes down as one of the first times I've ever seen bloodied hair next to me in the announce table. Here we go, Wojciech looking again for the mount. And she is just relentless, Dean.
I don't know whether to keep this lock of hair or
I think we should give it back. I think we should give it back
to her. If we keep it, we can clone her and then
we can have a little army.
A whole army of champions, yeah.
Here we go, back to the stalemate then. Wozniak is in the side control. Can't get the knee on the belly to mount.
It's interesting because Wozniak's actually blocking the mount on the other side. She might be trying to get the knee in here to gain some space, but she's not... Wait, there we go, just get a bit of leverage. She wasn't blocking the mount on that side, and Wojciech just couldn't implement the mount. She just allowed Wozniak to escape almost.
I think Wojciech is actually speeding up, Dick. It's remarkable. As we get deep into this fight, she's getting faster.
It could be she's just got gas tank for days.
She has.
And Wozniak's just been compromised throughout this back and forth battle and heavy punches from the right hands and the grappling exchanges. And this is often like, I call it like the Jedi skills or Jedi ability. You don't know what that takes out of you, what they're doing right now in the clinch up against the cage, unless you've been there. It really does sap you. You use all the muscles, all your pressure to take somebody down. And if you're defending, you're fighting with every bit of your being not to get taken down. And we're seeing that from Wozniak now. She's kind of lost a little bit of that ability to stop the takedown.
Yeah, Wozniak has taken her down now several times, and she really is starting to build up something of a lead here, certainly in this round. as I say, it seems like she's getting faster as Wozniak is slowing down. That's the end of the fourth round. So Karolina Wozniak, not bothered by the loss of her hair, has landed next to us. And I'd say she took that fourth round, Dean, as we approach the fifth and final round. As we watch the replay here, Wozniak on the feet, looking to land the shots.
And look at this, this outside trip. She circles around, trips the leg, straight into side control. You can see she's pushing the left leg through. Wozniak really wants to get that knee in. You can see here she gets the knee in, gets the space, kicks her opponent off her, and gets the space that she needs to get straight back to her foot. Technical stand-up from Wozniak.
Okay, so here we are, the fifth and final round. It's a very, very close fight indeed. You say maybe Wozniak took the first couple. You can make an argument that Wozniak has taken the last two. And as I say, it looks like Wozniak is the stronger of the two going into this round. We shall see, though, the final round that will decide the contender's strawweight world title. As my colleague Dean Midhat is taking a picture of the hair which has landed next to us. Very unusual, that, Dean.
This is hair of the Polish assassin.
Yeah.
There's decent genes in this hair.
Absolutely. Here we go then, fifth and final round. And again, look at Wozniak. She looks like she's in the first round, Dean. She's apparently unbothered by what's been going on. Let's see what Wozniak has got left in this fifth and final round.
Wozniak has made a career of this dominant pressure in the clinch, you know, pressuring her opponents with her striking style as well as her clinch work. And she's had to almost abandon the pressuring of the striking because you could argue that Wozniak has the more powerful hands in this fight. But this is MMA. She can use the grappling, she can use the clinch work, the kicks, the knees to further out, a more advantageous position.
Wozniak coming in again. Nice footwork there from Wozniak to angle away from the cage. Obviously, Wozniak wants to get hold of her. Strong work there from Wozniak, just spinning Wozniak off her. But she's relentless, Dean, just coming forward.
Wozniak now looking for that jab. Again, hands down, she's kind of moving too far forward, leaving her chin out. She's almost like she's reaching for these punches now.
And every time she throws a punch, Wozniak looks to just grab hold of her.
And the jab landed there from Wozniak. She's known for that. Again, the head snaps back of Wozniak.
And you can see exactly what Wozniak wants here. She wants to secure that takedown. Got to be wary, though, of the heavy hands of Evelina Wozniak. Still carrying the power in this fifth and final round. Markeith Dean Midhat here, main event of Contenders 27. We hope you're enjoying watching this at home as much as we are calling it for you. An absolutely absorbing scrap between two very high-level female fighters.
This is what you'll see when there's two high-level athletes in there. It's in the nuances, the little escapes, the little advances that you'll see between these two high-level and highly skilled fighters.
Neither fighter yet has really put a stamp on this fifth and final round. I get the feeling there's still a chapter to be written here, Dean.
Wozniak now just seems to be waiting a little bit longer to place that right hand, using the jab, pouring out. And it's Wozniak now, the one that's took center cage, and she's starting to pressure Wozniak backwards.
Wozniak doing a better job in this round, though, avoiding the kind of grappling attempts of Wozniak, Dean. She managed to struggle off a few times.
It's because she expects it. Also, she's got good lateral movement. She's circling round to her left and right. Big rush of punches here from Wozniak.
Wozniak's pouring it on here. Some good shots landed. As we hear the corner shout, 2 minutes in this fifth and final round. That was telegraphed there, a shot from Wozniak, Dean.
Again, she's got to make Wozniak believe she's going to try and land some decisive punches, not necessarily like she wants. That's why she's moving her head like that. That's why she's slipping, rolling the shoulder. She's saying, hey, look, I'm going to try and punch you. I'm moving my head because I want to strike you. And then she'll change levels and look for the clinch up against the cage.
Wozniak just wants to get her hands around Wozniak, press her to the cage, and look to take her to the floor. But Wozniak is doing a great job circling away, shrugging off those attempts.
Wozniak did a better job of timing the punches as well. She's worked out when the leg comes up, she can fire the punches upstairs.
She's seen her way in to land these punches. Even though there's not much power on the end of it, she's still racking up points and doing damage. And more importantly, setting that up. She's going to look to hip toss here. Wozniak pressuring up against the cage.
And look at this. This could be key. Will a takedown come from this? Because if it does, that would be massive in this round. Wozniak looking to press Vocek into the cage. She's very, very hard to hold, though. And here we go. She's spun it around, Dean.
And if you think about the earlier rounds of this fight, Wozniak was dominating in this position. Very strong. She was able to break away at will. And now she finds herself getting turned. Almost certainly, you know, the gas tank has been expended from those exchanges in the earlier rounds.
And you have to admire the tenaciousness of Karolina Wozniak. There's a grapple in front of us here, Dean. Any takedown out of this grappling exchange will be absolutely key.
Well, Wozniak's got double underhooks here. This is usually a dominant position to take somebody down. You know, this is a great position, a clinch. You've got a lot of control over the top half of the person's body. But look, Vocek shrugs it off, turns her around, then drops for a single immediately.
Can she get it? Can she get this takedown? This would be huge for Karolina Wozniak. And that is the end of the fight, Dean. What a high-level strawweight title fight here at Contenders 27. Very, very difficult to score. Both ladies showing some tremendous skills. What do you make of it?
Interesting back and forth. There's no question about it. Vocek's gas tank is insane. Look at the replay here. There's the jab that she's known for. She's found a home for it now. And she's picking the punches a lot more easier and using the strikes to set up the level change.
Outstanding fight. You can see Wozniak had some success here coming forward in that fifth and final round. And I don't think, I might be wrong, but I don't think Wozniak got it to the floor, did she, Dean, in that final round?
No, that would have been the icing on the cake. She tried to right at the end with that same outside trip that she'd had success with before. But again, a difficult one to score. You never know what the judges are going to see. That's potentially three different judges, three different perspectives, three different backgrounds in mixed martial arts or even traditional martial arts. So, you know, that's the old saying, guys, never leave it to the judges, but we're going to have to go to them in this instance.
Yeah, who'd be a judge, eh? That is a very, very tough fight to score. I don't know how you're scoring at home. Let us know, hashtag Contenders27 on Twitter, who you think won that. I wouldn't like to venture a guess, Dean. That final round was really, really close, if that's what it's all going to come down to. As we await the judges, they're tallying their scores. They're talking to MC Tom Vince now, and I think he's got the decision. So who is going to be the Contenders strawweight champion? We're about to find out. MC Tom Vince has the microphone. He's heading into the cage. Hold on to your seats. We're about to find out who the new queen of the strawweight division is here at Contenders.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for both these ladies here in the cage. What a great fight that was. You won't see better than that anywhere else in the world, ladies and gentlemen. After five hard-fought rounds, we have a split decision. Your winner and the Contenders strawweight champion in the ladies' division, in the blue corner, Yelena Wozniak. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Karolina Marta Wozniak. And we have CLS Global Solutions to present the belt to our new Contenders Ladies Champion, Yelena Wozniak.